We can't cover the history of any island in the Bahamas without looking at the church history. I'm standing here in the St. John's Native Baptist Church in South Victoria Hills in Salvador, and these are the Arnetts. Now, if I'm not mistaken, your father was pastor of this church at some point,
yes.
And then your father took over from him.
Right.
Okay, so tell me a little bit about that.
Okay, my father was 84 when he died. Mm-hmm. And he served here in this church as pastor of this church. Mm-hmm. A matter of fact, it took the whole of this area. We had people that came from all over the islands, mm-hmm. especially during special occasions like Christmas and New Year's, mm-hmm. when they rushed around in the church.
Okay.
And I can still remember hearing my dad say, "No back steps, because if you made back steps, it means you were dancing.
Wow.
But you can always rush forward."
Okay. All
and
right.
Then this was taken over by Adrana's dad, mm-hmm. Ernest Black,
okay.
who is my uncle.
Okay. This isn't just a regular walk through the native bushes of San Salvador for me. I am actually retracing the steps that my father, Wellington Francis, used to walk every day to school, down at the bottom to some of his other relatives. His house, the house where his family lived, was way past that house that you see in the distance. And they had actual roads that they walked every day. It's a special time for me because San Salvador is an island with so many treasures. No wonder the hand of God and fate led Columbus here. I mean, you think about it. An island with natural beauty like lakes and creeks and inland ponds. An island with beautiful shallow waters and deep ocean hues. It's just a beautiful place. I mean, it's a place that you can keep on rediscovering. There's so much to offer.
Glory, glory,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
glory, hallelujah.
Since I lay my burden down. Glory, glory,
glory, hallelujah,
hallelujah. Since I
lay my burden down.
Native show,
hallelujah.
Uncle Tom.
I'm glad.